All right. Welcome, welcome everyone to our Saturday evening social. We are going to be working on pages 13 and 16 of our journals, our March journals, working on our gratitude jar and our letter of gratitude. If for whatever reason you don't have a journal, it hasn't gotten there yet, you haven't ordered one yet, you can't find it, you left it at work, you can always do these on blank pieces of paper. You can do things on sticky notes, transfer it in later. It's not a problem. We're going to go through the prompts. Everything will be fabulous. So my name is Maya, and I am coming to you from Denver, Colorado, where it was very lovely and sunny, a little bit windy, but it was very sunny and very nice. Today it was getting into spring, so that's super, super exciting. And I know there are some people who were here this that were here with us this morning when Jennifer O was facilitating and I was stage managing. So welcome if you're coming back for a double dose of your Saunders socials. Love that you join us. And I think I saw some folks that were this is their first social, which if this is your first social, welcome. If it's your 501st social, I don't think we've actually had that many, but maybe close actually. So it doesn't matter. We love to see everyone here working on our journals, giving ourselves a little bit of that self-care time, setting aside some very specific time to work on our journals and taking that all important time for ourselves. So do make sure you set your chat to everyone. And I know if you're on a cell phone or an iPad, sometimes it keeps flipping back to the host and panelist. So keep an eye on that. And we'll try to kind of remind you if, you know, if that happens, because otherwise the only people who can see what you're putting in the chat are myself and my fabulous stage manager, Katie. She is here. Also, she will be, she's going to pop on and wave. Sometimes you can see her, sometimes you can't, depends on the settings you have, but she's there coming to us from Texas. And she will be helping in the chat if you're having any problems, any questions, not sure what page we're on, not sure what we're doing, those kinds of things. You can always check in there as well. She helps me keep an eye because sometimes that chat gets to going pretty quick, right? Let's see what else. I think we've got covered the basics there. So I do want to just remind everyone, or maybe it's the first time that you're hearing this, our Saunder Club, which is our app, and our Saunder socials are really a place for clarity, compassion, connection, and creativity, right? It's this place where you can unlock that mental clarity. You have compassion for yourself and others, making connections with others. We always have so many great ideas. Melissa, do not, I see folks, I'm so behind on my journaling. Don't beat yourself up, but you're not behind. You're right where you need to be, right? You just pick up and you go from here. There's no rules. We're not going to come take your journal away if you haven't filled out every page, right? This is here for you to help you get more out of yourself and out of your life. And sometimes we just don't have time to work on the journal. That's okay, right? So again, making that connection and our creativity. We have so many fabulously creative Saunder fam, and you'll get to see that when you see some of these examples of the fun gratitude jars. Just a few little norms that I like to remind everyone about, because, you know, again, it's kind of this virtual environment. We try very, very hard to keep this a very positive and uplifting and supportive environment, right? So with that in mind, we have these community guidelines where you're going to be kind and courteous, treating yourself and others with respect. You're going to respect folks' privacy, no hate speech or bullying. And remember, Saunders socials really are a tool to help you elevate your emotional health through the power of community, right? We've got this great community here, but ultimately you are responsible for your own emotions, well-being, and decisions. All right. So as you probably know, the month of March, our theme has been gratitude, which this theme has really resonated with a lot of folks. It feels so good. And you probably read in Meha's welcome letter that's at the beginning of your journal, how she really is this idea of gratitude. It's very, very hard to try to feel gratitude and stress at the same time, right? When we are feeling grateful for things and we are really grateful for what we have and we are thankful for what we have in our lives, a lot of times you can't physically have the stress, right? Because it just really kind of releases those. So many fabulous things that gratitude can do for us. And you probably notice if you've been with us for a while, we always have, there's usually a gratitude log or a gratitude jar or some place where you can kind of keep track. That daily gratitude reflection is so, so, so important. So here's our agenda. The first thing, unfortunately, I do have to remind you is that tonight is daylight saving time for most of the country. So I had found a fun little meme about jumping forward. So remember to set your clocks ahead. I know it's definitely not one of my favorite things, but as we were reminded in the morning social, it does give us more light in the evening for a while until the light kind of catches back up in the morning. So I just remember like the spring forward, grateful that that means that spring is coming. We're going to have more hours of daylight. We're going to have plants and birds and flowers, and our trees are going to come back up. So trying to be grateful for that, but remember to do that because it is sad we lose that hour of sleep. My sister is a nurse who works a 12-hour shift. She loves daylight saving time in the spring when she gets to jump forward and get an extra hour and get off early, but she still gets paid for it. So she's very grateful. All right. So we're going to do a little, what I like to call a gratitude warm-up activity, get you kind of in that mood. And then we're going to work on our gratitude jar and our letter of gratitude. All right. All right. So here's our first, like, again, I call these our warm-up activities. So we're going to flip to either a blank notes page. You could also use the scratch pad for the week. If you have one of the thoughts journals that we have, those fun blank journals that give you lots and lots of extra pages. If you've got sticky notes, if you have another journal that you, your supplemental journal, right, where you do a lot of your writing and those kinds of things, whatever works for you. But here's what you're going to do. In honor of the fact that the Oscars are tomorrow night, we are going to write our gratitude speech. And so what I want you to do is to reflect on an accomplishment that you have achieved in the past, or maybe think of a difficult decision you made, a difficult time you got through, something where you really had to use a lot of you, right? To push forward, to move forward, to have that accomplishment, to do that, right? Exactly. Jamie's like, I'd like to thank the Academy. Yes, you absolutely can thank the Academy, but you're going to write this award style speech acknowledging your own efforts for the situation. So here's an example for you. If you have not seen Snoop Dogg's acceptance speech for when he got his star on the Hollywood Walk of Fame, I highly recommend watching that. There is some salty language, so just be warned. It's Snoop Dogg, so I mean, but it's so cute because Amber's saying his speech is literally what she was about to type. It is so cute because he says, you know, I want to thank me for all my hard work, my dedication, my sacrifices. Like, he really acknowledges himself, right? And that's not to say that other people didn't help. He certainly wasn't saying that, but I think it's so important sometimes for us to acknowledge ourselves. So this was my acceptance speech, kind of thinking about my accomplishments in higher education. So I said, I want to thank me for all my hard work and perseverance when it came to my higher education accomplishments. I didn't have any family members who had gotten a bachelor's or a master's, and certainly not a PhD, but I pushed myself. I asked questions. I made sacrifices. I got through all the classes, the reading, the papers, the group projects. I am smart and strong, and I accomplished all of that. I did have support from friends and family, but ultimately it was me who pushed to get it done, to keep on keeping on. So thanks to me, I rock. All right. So that's my little example. You do you, but I really want you to thank yourself. I know there's a quick temptation to thank everybody else, and you can certainly do that maybe in a second paragraph, but remember, we're at the Academy Awards, and you know how they pull you off and start playing the music if you talk too long. So I'm going to play some music. I'm going to let you write this out. Feel free to share anything you would like in the chat. I'm going to go off camera, play some music, and I'm going to let you write your speech. All right, here we go. All right. I love the speeches you all are writing, the things that you're thanking yourselves for, you know, keeping your family together through struggles, right? For maybe leaving a job that maybe while it paid well, wasn't giving you joy, was maybe had toxic work environment, was making it so you couldn't spend time with your family. Against all, so many of our Sonderfam folks are really working hard to stay strong, to deal with so much adversity. And so I really, really want to thank you for being here, giving yourself some time, and thanking yourselves, right? And save this letter, right? This is a good one to pull out, this little blurb that you wrote in here when you're maybe feeling low, when you're maybe struggling a little bit, thinking maybe, oh, I can't do anything. This is too hard, right? Pull this out, remind yourself, you can do hard things, right? And you have done hard things. And this is a great reminder for you to be able to see on a regular basis. So thank you all so much for sharing, for being vulnerable in, you know, in the chat with kind of sharing with others some of the different things that you said. I saw somebody said they wrote, their hand hurt because they wrote a whole page. So love that, love that. All right. So now we've got that. So we might want to take a deep breath, just kind of just sit here for a second and kind of hold on to that. Think about all those good thoughts that you thought for yourself, all those things that you maybe remembered, but really are grateful for experiences, for things that you were able to get through. So very nice work. All right. So now we'll turn to one that hopefully won't make your hand hurt, or maybe it will. Maybe there'll be a lot of drawing. I don't know. But this is our gratitude jar. And every month, like I said, we always have something that deals with recording our gratitude. Sometimes it's a gratitude log. Sometimes it's like the pretty little sunset looking graphic. Sometimes it's a jar. We also do have the gratitude gumball, which I think we're doing in a separate social. But really that idea of practicing some sort of gratitude. And so you might look at this jar and be like, what the heck am I supposed to do with this jar? Like, how do I put gratitude in here, right? So I'm going to show you some fabulous examples, again, from our wonderful, wonderful Sonderfam. So some people just write, like that one up in the top left where they just kind of wrote some different things that they were grateful for. I like the one on the bottom under that with like the little, it has little bubbles with little things in them. Again, words kind of anyway. There's one that has really pretty colored blocks where you could write different things in. The one underneath that with the really cool triangles with the numbers. So each day of the month, they wanted to kind of put something in each area that they were grateful for. The one next to that, they're doing me time. So they're grateful for me time. They may like have different ones on every single line that they put in there. Love the fireflies up at the top, right? So pretty and little things that they're grateful for. You could always draw little flowers as springtime is coming. Use stickers, right? Stamps, anything like that. I have lots of examples for you. So here's some other ones that are really fun. I love the with the words and kind of this, what am I grateful for? And just all the different things kind of written out. Yeah, Christine's saying trying to do one for each day this month. Absolutely. I like the one in the middle that's kind of this, it's almost kind of like a beehive kind of look with the little bubbles and kind of colored in the backgrounds. The one next to it has the fun little red panda stickers. So love that. And lots of different things that they were grateful for throughout that month. Super fun, like looks like little scraps of paper that they drew and have like the little things that they're thankful for. You know, this is the other thing. We have had some people actually make real life gratitude jars. So they get a mason jar or they get like a water bottle that they're not using or whatever. And then they just kind of write little things and put in there. The other one on the right there, they have fun little ice cubes that they can write different things that they're grateful for. And then the one on the bottom, I love the angle of this because it makes the jar look really 3D and the shading and the coloring that they did. But again, lots of little words in there. And then if for whatever reason you think, well, I don't necessarily want to do a gratitude jar, maybe you're logging gratitude somewhere else. They changed it to random things to do, right? So you can always repurpose your gratitude jar for something else. Maybe it's self-care activities that you want to do for the for the month, or maybe it's books you want to read, or maybe it's movies you want to watch or something like that. But you're just kind of, again, thinking of that, like capturing it in a jar, just kind of having this jar of all these different things. And yes, I know sometimes people look at this and think, oh my gosh, I wish I was that artistic, right? Don't necessarily think that you have to be artistic. Drawing can be something that you have to take time and get better at. You can always kind of, again, you can just write words, those kinds of things. Don't let comparison be the thief of joy, right? So this, our gratitude jar. I am grateful that we have so many other fabulous people, because my drawings, I would not have drawings like this. Sometimes I just kind of do little geometrical shapes, right? So I'm going to just place lots of music, let you work on your gratitude jar. Let us know if maybe you're repurposing it, if you're doing some different things, maybe what you're putting in there, how you're working on this. And we'll check back in here in just a few minutes. Thank you. Such a creative group we have. I love all the fun different ideas of things that people do. And I kind of popped some other ideas in there too, because remember, yes, we absolutely want to be capturing gratitude, but sometimes you capture it somewhere else. So anything, I always think anything I want to capture in a jar. So I had shared that I did one time when I was trying to do the no spending, no impulse spending on the internet, because goodness knows the Instagram and Facebook ads always get me. So, well, and I shouldn't say that's too bad, because that's how I found Silk and Sonder 3 years ago. But so in my jar, I kept things that I thought about buying, but didn't, and like wrote down how much it was. You would be surprised how much money was in the jar at the end of the month. So fun things, all these different fun ways. And again, I know we like to say like, I'm not an artist, or I can't draw anything in there, but Nona had a great suggestion with that. You know, I was like, just try, right? Just do something. Nobody has to see it. Try with a pencil and you can erase it, right? A lot of times I do, you know, I'll do some of my drawings in pencil first so that I can erase it if I don't like it, or kind of change things up. Draw on a scratch piece of paper to kind of test it out. But just try, right? Just kind of, oh, gumdrops. I love the idea. Gumdrops or gumballs. If you've got stencils, sometimes using those, finding little stars or kind of whatever you want to put in there. But it's so fun to just kind of have this little jar to kind of take with you and to look at, and just to kind of see all these different things. So you've seen all these fun things. Always be sure, if you're comfortable sharing your pictures, sharing those inspirations in Sonder Club, because that's where we get all of our examples from. So you never know, you might see one of your pictures up here one day, or other people in the community will see that and maybe be inspired by it. So I know lots of people are going to run out and get stickers or get stencils, or stamps are another really fun thing. You can get some fun ink colors and get some fun stamps to kind of put in there. So lots of fun ideas, just a fun place to just kind of get creative and let yourself just kind of have fun with that space that you've got there, right? So many different fun ways to do these things. All right. So now we've had some fun. We've got some fun things that we're grateful for, or gratitude or whatever, happiness. I love the idea of a laughter jar or a dad jokes jar, or maybe it's a yummy restaurants jar where you can put the names of different restaurants and your favorite dish. Again, this is a place for you to let your creative imagination flow when you do this work. So now we're going to dive into our letter of gratitude, right? So some more writing. So hopefully everybody's hands, and maybe you want to do a few wrist exercises, kind of make sure that you're ready to do a little bit of writing. And again, you might want to write this on a scratch piece of paper. You might want to write this on sticky notes or something, and then transfer it over later if you're worried about kind of what things are looking like. So this is on page 16 in your March journal. And you are going to write a letter to someone you are grateful for, or someone who's been influential in your life. So again, you can write this to yourself, or I have some ideas for you. You could write it to maybe a teacher. Maybe it was a K-12 teacher. Maybe it was someone in undergrad, graduate school. Maybe it's your parents, one of your parents, both of your parents. Friends, siblings, children, your spouse, significant other, coworker. Maybe it's someone you only know from being online. Maybe it's just a random person in the grocery store who was nice to you, right? Think about someone that you're grateful for, or maybe someone who has been influential in your life, who helped you kind of fill your cup, or maybe who helped you get through some tough times, right? Or maybe someone who was there to help celebrate when the tough times were over, someone who kind of helped you in that way, or inspired you in some way to maybe change something kind of about how you would go. And yeah, I definitely agree with these letters. A lot of times I like to do some drafts. I know people think, oh, I don't want to mess up my journal. I don't want to make it icky. You would not believe, I finally had to get over the whole, yes, I can scribble things out of my journal. It's going to be okay. None of us are going to show up at your house and knock on the door and make you show us your journal, and you're going to get it taken away because there's a scribble in it, right? Again, but I know what that feels like, wanting to make this look really nice. So again, drafting it out, on that scratch paper, drafting it back of an envelope, right? Kind of whatever. And yes, Nona is recommending, it's a good idea to have tissues for this one. Oftentimes, as we are writing and as we are kind of telling someone how grateful we are for them and for the things that they've done, it gets a little teary, and that's okay, right? So in your letter, here's just a few suggestions for things to think about as you write it. Maybe you want to give an overall summary, of why you're grateful for this person. Why are you grateful? Dear so-and-so, I am so grateful for you because, right? And then maybe give some specific details about this person and their impact on your life, right? And, or maybe you want to also tell them how your life would have been different without their influence or their help, right? So just take a minute. Again, I'm going to put some music on for you to think and just maybe take a minute, close your eyes, kind of think about who this person is, visualize who the person is, visualize what they did for you, visualize how your life might have been different, visualize how they helped you, visualize kind of what that felt like, what you, maybe you even want to visualize a particular time, like what you were doing, what was happening, where you were, what they said, any of those kinds of things. And then just start writing. Don't edit yourself. That's why it's good to have a scratch piece of paper. Just start letting that flow. It's that pen to paper that really just kind of gets all this good stuff out. All right. So you're welcome to share anything that you're thinking of in the chat. You're welcome to just focus completely on the letter and ignore the chat, listen to the music, any combination of that. But let us know if you want to, like who you're writing to, kind of what that looks like. And again, we'll check back in here and wrap things up in a bit. You've got plenty of time. Don't rush yourself. Maybe you want to do bullet points before you write the letter, doing your draft, writing it out later in your journal, whatever works for you. But this is a really good time to think about that person who you're grateful for. Thank you. Right. Believe it or not, we are at the end of our hour. I hope that was enough time for you to get started on your letters. I know some people had written three letters, right? People were coming up with lists of folks that they wanted to send letters to. I love the sentiment of really being able to kind of reach out to people who have made a difference in our lives. And, you know, sometimes I think we assume they know, or we think that they won't be interested in knowing. I can tell you, I will never be not wanting to hear someone tell me that they were grateful for something that I did. Every once in a while, somebody will tell me something that they were grateful for something I did years ago. And it's, I mean, I'm one of those, like, gosh, I don't remember that, but that is, I'm so glad to hear that I've made a difference. So whether or not you can share this letter with the person that you wrote it to, I think that's the writing the letter is a great start. And you all did such a fabulous job of being vulnerable, of sharing with us. And if you weren't able to share, that's absolutely fine too as well. I hope you were all able to work on your letters. Again, think about doing this as something maybe on a regular basis. Like I said, can you imagine if we all shared our gratitude with all the people that have made an impact in our lives and they shared? And I just think the world would be a lot nicer of a place, which I think we need a lot of that right now. So thank you all so, so much for joining us this evening. Please feel free, if you would like to share your pages, you certainly are under no obligation to do so. But again, people really love to see examples of things that folks do in some of these socials. So we do have a couple QR codes here. There's the Refer a Friend program. You get $10, they get $10. You can also share your feedback. I think you'll get a link in an email as well to share your feedback in the survey. So you can ask for if you would prefer other times, other socials, other things that you can think of, let them know that. Katie will also put the link for the YouTube channel in the chat. That's where you can go to view any of the past socials, not the exclusive events that have a charge. The ones that have a charge are only the link. There's a special link for folks from those, but all the other ones, all of our others that are included in the Silk and Sonder club. So, and here's my playlist. I'll drop a link in there as well, so you can kind of see the music that was in there. Hopefully, I know we've got a couple setups tomorrow, I think. Lots of setups, more fun socials. So love to see you there. Have a fabulous, fabulous evening. Don't forget, or maybe I should phrase it positively, remember to set your clocks ahead when you go to bed so you wake up and you know what time you're in the right time zone there, unless you're in Arizona, because I don't think they change their clocks. But otherwise, thank you all so much. Have a fabulous, fabulous rest of your weekend, and hopefully we will see you again soon.